I'm going to talk about the some of the personality theories. The last class we are discussing the basics of the personality. What is meaning? What is the meaning of the personality? Then parallel we are discussing the factor influencing the personality, and we discuss about the some of the general types of the personality also in the last classes. The last class. So today the main focus of my today's presentation. The personality theories. In this, I may focusing only the type theories. If you look onto the some other textbook, you might see the lot of personality theories like type theories, trait theories, type come trait theories, then psychoanalytic theories, then humanistic approach. Like there are plenty of plenty of personality theories are available. But in our MS syllabus, only few of them is listed out there. There in the psychology syllabus. We are incorporating the type theories. In the type theory, there is a 3 or 4 authors based theories are there. Parallelly, the trait theories also. Then type come trait theory also, some of the authors based theories are incorporated in our syllabus. Then psychoanalytic theory, finally the humanistic approach theory. This much theories are there. After this, our psychology, particularly the unit number 4, it gives the some of the importance for the personality analysis. Assessment, like what are the tools is made good for the personality assessment. That is another part of the personality unit. Here, I may focusing only the type theories. So today, in this type theory, also, I may focusing only the two types, only two theories. One is called Kretschmer's theory, as well as the Seldon. These are the two theories only I may focusing today. See, what is a type theory? There is a difference between the type theory, type come trait theory, humanistic theory, as a psychoanalytic theory. But what is exactly type? So that term itself, you can understand what is type. So if you are classified, if you classify, the term is important. If you are classified or categorize the people's personality in basis of the physic as well as the temperament. Actually, there is a association between the physics and temperament, according to some of the psychologists. So that psychologist, what they did in the sense, based on the physics of the people, they are associated with some kind of personality characteristics. They combine together, they classify the people's types. Therefore, it's called as a type theory. The type theory normally is explained the personality of the people based on the physics and the temperament. This is called type theory. Actually, their intention to divide the personality of the people into different types. That type, how they generate in the sense, based on the physics, the outlook of the people, and they are giving some kind of associations, their temperament also. There is a chance. It's not, we cannot come for any conclusion about the body types. Those are very lean, they are very adamant. Those are very fat, they are very lazy. That kind of general assumption we cannot come. But lot of psychologists highlight that there is a chance the physics also may influence the temperament. That is why in the last class or so, what I discussed to you, the factors influencing the personality, the first factor is a physical factor. There we are discussing about this biological factors, then chemical factors, then like nerves factors. These are the factors that we discuss. So it means that there is a chance our physics may give some kind of influences in the personality or in the characteristics. That is why the previous, these are the theories more than 100 years back. But now if it adopt or not, it's a hypothetical question only. Sometimes this kind of theory is not be acceptable now. Because this kind of theory is made by more than 100 years before. Actually, this theory is made in 1940. Some of the theories is more than 100 years, 18th century and all. But this series started in the first theory I'm focusing on, the Seldon theory. The Seldon theory is talking, it started, created the Seldon theory. He provided the Seldon theory to the world in the year 1940 only, but more than 60 years over. But in the current situation, whether the particular theory may apt in the sense, it won't be apt because sometimes the physics as well as the way of food habits. So now you may know that the way of food habits totally changed for us, and the body type, it's not only blanks to, it's not only basics on the genes. Based on the food habits, based on the environment, the body type also been changing now. That is why we cannot come for any conclusions about the the comparisons of the physics and temperament in this current scenario. But this kind of theories they made more than 60 years and 100 years before. And what they highlight in the sense, these things you already understand what is a physics. Physics in the sense body, the body type. So the body type normally we are dividing to lean persons, normal person, normal body type, or very fat body. Like that, we generally come for any conclusion after seeing the after first look itself the people's. We can come for some conclusions. But the case of the temperament, we cannot come for any conclusion within a single eye reading itself. But the temperament here refers the person's mood, the functions, the person tensions, then how he is doing the excitement, how he is showing the feeling to others. These are the things may come under the temperament. So that particularly one psychologist, he is very much concentrate. He 100% arguing that there is a 100% of association happened between the physics and temperament. That's the name of the particular psychologist called Seldon. That thing's only I'm focusing now. He's a man, Seldon. So I hope you are seeing the photos of him. So what he highlight in the sense, he generated the theory in the year 1940, and he did lot of research. Particularly, he attempted the research for the case of the delinquent children as well as the normal people. He is comparing the delinquent children as well as the normal people based on the body type, and he comparing the delinquent people how much doing the crime, whether the crime is any way to be associated with the body type. This kind of research he attempted. Then finally he generated a theory in the name of somatic types. Actually, this theory may come as somatic type. Why? In the sense, the type, he divide the peoples based on the body type. Therefore, generally we may use the term as a somatic. He's a man to coin the term of a constitutional psychology. So what is the constitutional psychology accounting in the sense? We may treat it our body as a constitution. So that body, it may influence much on our personality. That's why he used the coin the term constitutional psychology to capture the link between or association between the personality and physical attributes. And he conducted and he concluded also the relationship existed between the one body type and personality, particularly the physique and trait. So those who are very good, very strengthened body, like athletic body. Those are having the good athletic body, they may involve some kind of crime activity according to him. And he divided the peoples based on the body type into three types. One is called ectomorphic, mesomorphic, and third one is called endomorphic. See, the differences among the three terms, ecto represent very lean. Ecto means those are very lean people, they may use the term as ectomorphic. Mesomorphic, those are having the normal body type, they are called as a mesomorphic. The last type, those are very fat, they are called as an endomorphic. But these three types, it may call, generally we may treat it as a somatotype theory, because he attempt the theory, he compare, he associate the how the body type, it may link with personality or the characteristics of the persons. So he compare these two important things. Just I'm moving to the next level of his theory. This theory is published by him in the 1942. The terms of the theories, somatotypes. He argued that an individual body shape was correlated with the personality, as I already mentioned. And he did a research for the 300 male body types. He characterized the three main body types. So we may cross a lot of people, but he also did a research for 300 people. He categorized the 300 people in a three order and three types based on the body structure. Based on the body structure. And he is given some kind of interpretation that this body type persons may be this kind of characteristics. This body type people having this kind of characteristics. Like this, he suggested also based on his research. This is a theory is talking. So this image, it may give you much meaning about this particular theory. See, who is ectomorphic? In the sense, those are very lean. Those are very lean. You know the body structure of the lean persons. they may very lean. You could not find the lot of muscles in the body. So only you may see the only the skeleton only, but in the skeleton, the muscles may be surrounded. That's only we know. Then the case of the mesomorphic, they are the normal body type people. They have athletic, normal. Normally, even in the case of those who are studying the statistics, you may find out the terminology is called normal property curve. So in the normal property curve, in the case of the cutosis, we may use the term as the mesocortic, meso. M, the meso represents normal. Whenever you are finding the terms meso, it is a terms represent a normal. Normal. See, this is a normal property curve. See this case, this is called normal property curve. When we can call as a normal property curve in the sense, if it is normal, if you divide the normal property curve in the center, you may get the 50% of both the sides. So the same manner, in the case of mesomorphic, the people, so once you divide, you are getting the two equal parts. It's like a normal people. So most of the people's may lies on the particular body type only. Therefore, it's called as mesomorphic, the terms itself they're highlighting. And those are very fat, they are called as an endomorphic. Those are very fat, they are called as an endomorphic. He given some kind of interpretations that this body type people having this kind of characteristics. This mesomorphic having some kind of characteristics like that, he categorized that things I will focus on here. So before going to deeply about the ectomorphic, endomorphic, mesomorphic, just I'm going to show one video. From this, you may understand whether the theories may be suitable or not, because we cannot come for any conclusion about the this kind of thing, because some cases it won't be correct. See this case, Charlie Chaplin. So can you tell whether Charlie Chaplin is ectomorphic or endomorphic or mesomorphic? So can you type in the chat box what kind of body type is having in the case of the Chaplin? Chaplin is very lean, so he's a ectomorphic. Exactly, he's an ectomorphic. But according to this Selden, he highlighted that ectomorphics are very introvert. He won't talk too much. He always self-confessed. He may thinking by himself only. That kind of introvert characteristics only. But see this case of the in his films and all, he's very active. And he make the people's humor. So he's acting. From this, he's enjoying us. So some of the cases not be correct. That is the best example, Chaplin. Video in the sense, even this case has happened more than 60, 70 years before. That time also, this theory is not adopted in the case of the, it's not be correct in the case of the Charlie Chaplin. But I don't know exactly about his individual characteristics. So I hear some of the book anecdotes from this. I can understand that he's very self-conscious based on it, as well as he's very introvert also. But in the case of the social based movement, he's not that much of introvert. So sometimes in the school days, as in the after the children's life, he may very much subconscious, very much conscious, social self-conscious. Then once you go for the adolescent stage, he might involved in all the activity. That's why his behavior may change. That is why some of the psychologists may highlight that there is a chance environment also may influence much on the person's personality. But this type here is focusing only the body type and the relationship of the characteristics. Just I'm moving to the first type, endomorphic. Endomorphic, we also called as a visceronotonic. So the endomorphic, generally I already mentioned that this also come under the somatotype. Therefore, we may, whenever you are using the term as endomorphic, you can compare the term also. Normally, an endomorphic somatotype is also known as a visceronotonic. The characteristic traits of the somatotype usually include being relaxed, tolerant, comfortable, and sociable. So it means that they're very happy to meet the people. They are very happy. They're social. Sociable in the sense they are very, they are extrovert. So they are always happy to meet the people. They are making fun to others. That kind of characteristic the endomorphic people having. And the body type, see the body shapes normally how it will look in the sense, they have the wide hips and narrow shoulders. We may generally call them say barrel, okay, because the body shapes look like barrel types. Therefore, some of the psychologists, they may use the term as a barrel of fun, because they are the fun nature. Therefore, some of the psychologists, they may use the term as the endomorphic PSA, barrel of fun people. And the physical characteristics they are very round, so barrel face. And the next body shapes, lot of fat on the body. This also because they are very fat. Automatically, the entire body having the lot of muscles, fat muscles only. Lot of fat on the upper arms and thighs. So that is a bigger challenge for them. Normally, this body type, in what manner it influences the sense? It influences some kind of laziness to them. What kind of laziness in the sense? They don't like walk much. Because if they watch walks in this in small distance, automatically they have some kind of breathing issues may come. That is why they don't like to walk much. So that body type, it makes some kind of influence in the normal psychological character, like laziness and all. That laziness may lead to some other characteristics. Generally, the endomorphic people have this kind of temperament. So this kind of characteristics. What are the characteristics? Psychologically, they are very sociable. They love to eat food. They love to eat food. See, that image also is showing. They are fun-loving. They are always happy. Even some people, you may cross. Some cases may be true also. Even I cross some of the very fat people. But whenever we are sitting with them, we feel much comfortable with them, because they won't make harmful. They speak also very polite. And whenever they're talking us, it's some kind of comic sense they may incorporate. That kind of lot of comic sense they have, this kind of people. And love of food, they have much tolerant. They won't angry immediately. They have the lot of tolerant characteristics. They're good humored nature. They are very relaxed. They won't bother about anything. Suppose one person are walking 10 kilometer speed, they won't bother about anything. So they may go very patiently. They are not comparing with others and all. So they live their life very comfortably. And with the love of comfort. So they always making the friendship in very colorful manner, as well as the very close manner. So these are the characteristics of the visceronectonic people. These people also called as an endomorphic. Generally, these endomorphic people are very fat nature. So this is things we already mentioned. Now I move to the second type. This is not said by me. This is said by the Selden only. That is why I told, now this kind of theory, we cannot come for any kind of any kind of conclusion that those are very lean, they are very cunning fellow. That kind of conclusion we cannot come, because sometimes it may not be correct. It's not a general output, a general predictions. Because sometimes some group it may work, but some group of people is not be working. So that is why the Selden, what he did in the sense, he comparing most of the people's, he did the research, most of the people are the delinquent people. Delinquent, so those who are having some kind of ethical issue, that people's only he did their research. From this only he coined this kind of, what is the theory. So therefore sometimes the sample he selected, it may be wrong. So that is why we cannot come for any kind of conclusion about this body type people having this kind of characteristics. But sometimes it may match. There is a proverb in Tamil, I hope in Malayalam also. So if you know this proverb, you can tell. Generally, the local people may highlight this word. Narambanukku narambalam vesam. So narambanukku narambalam vesam. I don't know what is in Malayalam. If anyone highlight the term, so I will convert into Malayalam, in English. Those are very lean. So naramb means that you know nerves. So all the nerves of the nerves, those are very lean. Each nerve is a poison, like there's a proverb. So normally in the colloquially we are using these terms. Narambanukku narambalam vesam, like this. Any proverb like this in Kerala, that kind of terminology here you're using. So if you know the term, use the proverb, you can tell me. So this is normally we are using in Tamil Nadu. So anyway, no problem. That terminology itself, we can easy to understand the characteristics of the lean people. So it may work, it may have to be more than 150 or 60 people, not now. According to the Selden, the ectomorphic behavior, he highlighted that the ectomorphic is complete opposite of the endomorphic keeper. So what are the good things you have found in the endomorphic? You could not find that things in the ectomorphic construction. They are parallel. Endomorphic is directly opposite of the ectomorphic. So both are, the two sides of the coin. So that both characteristics won't be matched to each other. Normally, the ectomorphic is the form of opposite of the endomorphic physically as well as the personality characteristics wise also. The general physical look normally for this people, narrow shoulders and hips, because they don't have hips as well as the shoulder also. A thin narrow face, and the face also very lean. See his face, very lean, very narrow look. A thin and narrow chest and abdomen. There is no abdomen also, there is no stomach. Then how the abdomen you can see. Thin legs and arms, very little body fat. So these are the body-based shapes for them. If you deeply look onto the characteristics of the people in the temperament, he categorized the some kind of characteristics. It may apt, this may associate with the ectomorphic people. One is called self-conscious. So they're very conscious. They are thinking always by their growth. They are not thinking about the other people's end up. So they're very conscious in the sense they work only their works only. So they are not having that much of open-mindedness to help others and all. That is a characteristics of the ectomorphic according to the Seldon. They are very private. So normally private in the sense they won't tell their personal issues or personal happiness to others. Always keep everything by themselves. They are introverted. They are very reserved. That's why I told in the case of the endomorphic, they are very enjoyable persons, very social person, but they are totally opposite. They are very reserved. They won't interact much to the people. Then socially anxious, they have some kind of fear when they see the lot of crowds. That's why socially anxious. But they have good characteristics like artistics, because those are very introvert. They have a lot of thinking power. That thinking power, it creates some kind of creativity sense. That creative sense, it develops some kind of artistics, like they are good drawing, they are good musicians, like that's some kind of creative things they have. They are emotionally controlled, because the body type also highlight that he's not able to fight with others. That's why he may come, he don't go for fight with others and all. And they are thoughtful, because they are always thinking by themselves. That thinking, the thinking process of private thinking process may helping to think in a different perspectives. So that's why most of the lean people have some kind of creativity sense. This is said by the Seldon only. Then the last type is called mesomorphic. They are so called as somatotonic. So what is the somatotonic? The term somatotonic represent those are having the normal body type. They are called as a somatotonic. Normally, the mesomorphic is in between the endomorphic and ectomorphic. They are also having the attractive and desirable body type. So they have the very good muscles, very tight muscles, and very attractive body type they have. The mesomorphic somewhere between the round endomorphic and the thin ectomorphic. Physically, they have the more desirable body and have, because the body shapes, no, it tempt them to fight with others. Because those are very gym type body, automatically they have some kind of self-confidence comes to fight others. So that leads to adventures, courageous, this kind of assertive characteristics may come, those are having this kind of body type. And they're physically, the body, it looks like this. They have the large head, broad shoulders and narrow waist, muscular body with strong forearms and thighs, and very little body fat. So because they don't have the fat body type, they have the fat, but very tight fat. So that fat may, compare into some kind of good muscular body to them. These are some of the psychological behavior of the people. They are very adventurous, because the body type, it leads them to give some kind of self-confidence. That's all. Self-confidence leads to attempt any kind of adventure. They are very courageous, indifferent to what others think, and they are somewhat unique. They won't accept others' ideas. They are thinking in their own perspectives. They are very assertive, very bold. They are very like to do some kind of physical exercise like jumping, walking, running, swimming. This this kind of things, they are very much concentrate and very competitive in nature. So they won't sit in a single place. So they are accepting all the challenges. They are having some kind of spirit, all the sports spirit and other spirit also they have, with a desire for power and dominance and love of risk and chance. So this kind of general characteristic they have. So I hope now you understand the exact difference between the difference among the three body type. This is said by the Selden in 1942. He highlighted that the body type we can divide into three based on the body structure. That body structure may correlate or may associate with some kind of personality characteristics. That are things only I am focusing, you know, in the image I am focusing. See, this case, the endomorphic, the tendency towards the roundness, the endomorphic people, I already identified as a very fat people. They are called as a barrel. So they are look like a barrel face, barrel things. Then mesomorphic is very lean people, sorry, a mesomorphic. The ectomorphic, sorry, mesomorphic is a normal people. Then ectomorphic is a very lean people. So in this image, the C is here, ectomorphic, B is a mesomorphic, then diagram A is here, endomorphic. This is thing, and this is a study attempted by the Selden. What he attempted, see here, he attempted, he selected 200 normal college students and 200 male delinquents. So he took the two group of people, one is the normal students, other one is the delinquent people, but the two groups are 200. And he's having some kind of measuring. In this measurement, the maximum score is 7. So he observed the people and he, fixed some kind of average for the 7 mark. So he compared with separate the students as well as the delinquents. See the rate scores he found. Nearly 200 people are observed. Out of 200, some of the people are endomorphic, some of the people are ectomorphic, some of the people are mesomorphic. So what he did, put some mark for the endomorphic people of the students community. So out of 200, sometimes it may be 75 or 80. So he observed it and give the mark out of 7. From this, he found that endomorphic people, they get 3.2. In the case of the delinquent group, the 3.4. So 3.4 is there. So in the case of the ectomorphic, see this case, 3.4 out of 7. In the ectomorphic, the delinquent, very few people are delinquent. The characteristic 1.8 only. But the mesomorphic, the rating is 3.8. And parallelly, the delinquents rate also 5.7 out of 7. So it may high. So from this, you can conclude that who is doing lot of crime in the sense, those are having the body type of mesomorphic. So he's come to general conclusion that those are good having the mesomorph, those are having the athletic body type, they're doing lot of crimes. So this is a theory he made from this kind of study only. I can move to the next theory. That is the theories talking about the Kretschmer classifications. This is theories look like on the same theory which we discussed in the previous of the Selden theory. The theories both is look like the same. He is also under the type theory contributor only, because he is also divide the people based on the body type, but instead of dividing the people into three body types, he divided into four. The same kind of body type, lean and fat and normal, but one more body type he made is unproportional. Sometimes some people are unproportional way of fat. We could not find that kind of fatness the people based on some kind of gene issue or some kind of physical issue that people they move for the very fat, sometimes very very lean. That people may come to the fourth category. He keep it and he coined some of the characteristics of the people also that I may focusing here one by one. This is a man, German psychologist. He's a psychiatrist and he worked in Marburg University. He's known as for this typology. Why is called typology? In the sense, his theory may come under the name of type approach theory. So he's a man, German psychologist, has attempted to correlate physique and character. So he's also did the same thing. He attempted to correlate the physique and character. From his studies, on mental passion. So see, this is he is also not observing the normal being much. He is also observing the mentally disordered people only. From this only he generated this kind of theory. Parallelly, the Sultan also, he observed most of the people of the delinquent people. He is also not much attend the degree for the normal people. Even he compared the normal people as well the delinquent, but much time he is working to attend the study for the some kind of delinquent people. So the similarly, the Krishman also attempted to find the correlation of physics and character, but his studies on the mental patients, he found that certain body types are associated with particular types of mental disorders. So previously the Sheldon highlighting that some characteristics, but he is in the Krishman highlighting that there is kind of some kind of mental disorder if the person having very, they are very lean in the sense, those are very fat, they are having some kind of mental disorder. Like that, he classified the people in some kind of disorder also based on the character. These are the four types according to the Kretschmer. The same kind of the classifications made by the Sheldon, he is also attempted, but the things he divided into four. What are the four in the sense? One is asthenic, athletic, painic, and dysplastic. So in this athenic, so the pronouns AS should be silent, so we need to call as the athenic. Athenic represent lean body, so in this case their case is called ectomorphic. Then athletic, here he used the term athletic. In the case of the Sheldon, he is using the term mesomorphic. Then Krishmer using the fat body type as a penic, but he is using the Sheldon used as a endomorphic. Whenever you are learning, you can compare the type of the theories, then you won't be forget the same terminology only. There, the Sheldon using the ectomorphic, he is using the athenic. Sheldon using as a mesomorphic, he is using the athletic. Sheldon using the endomorphic, he is using the picnic. Then parallelly, he is giving the another type is called dysplastic. So this is called unproportional body. What it means in the sense, we cannot predict that people are this much of lean or this much of fat. So sometimes unproportional body types also sometimes there's a chance some people's having unproportional, very very fat, very very lean. That people's may lies on the unproportional people. I'm going to highlight the people characteristic one by one. Then asthenic type, these people will have the slender or slim body, so that body knows, and they will have the personality traits of extroverts. They will have the personality traits of introvert because they are very lean, so that's why I put the unsociable, reserved, shy, sensitive, and pessimist. So these are the general characteristics of the ectomorphic in the case of Sheldon. The same thing here, unsociable, he's unreserved, he won't talk too much, he's very shy to interact with the people, but he's taking everything very sensitive, and he's always not an optimist, he's a pessimist, he's always thinking the negative things. And these people are prone to suffer from this series of mental disorder called disorder is called as a xerophonic. This is a disorder. This terms also is said by the Krishmer only. Those who are having this kind of body type, they have some kind of mental disorder. That mental disorder type is called xerophonic. Apparently, I'm showing some videos of the Mr. Bean, because previously you've seen the video of the Charlie Chaplin. In the year 1990s, the 1950s and all, we are seeing much videos of the Mr. Bean in 1980s and all, but now he's not in the picture. Even the Mr. Bean also somewhat athenic. He's not the normal or athletic type body type. He's also somewhat lean one. Not that much of lean compared to the Charlie Chaplin. He's somewhat okay, but he's also made treated as athenic. But in the social life, he's not showing the reservedness, sternness to others. Because if you have the shy or the reservedness, he cannot go for the cinema field and all. So sometimes the controversy may happen. The exception always there in some cases. Now I move to the second type, athletic. According to the Sheldon, this is called as an mesomorphic. So here the Krishmer, the athletic people, he made some kind of classifications. In this, he highlighted that these people will have the slender and slim body. They have the, sorry, they are athletic, no? So the people will have the strong body type. They have the very good strong body type. They are more energetic and more aggressive because the body type, it leads them self-confidence. The self-confidence leads them to show the aggressiveness to others. They will be strong enough to determine adventure and balance. They are comparable with ambivert. There is a term you may find out, even the Carl Jung, he added the two terms only, introvert and extrovert. But sometimes, some situations, sometimes we may introvert, sometimes we are extrovert. Therefore, most of the time, the people are ambivert, in between. Sometimes, because all the people will not come for conclusion that he's always an introvert, always he's an extrovert. Sometimes, based on the environment, he may change his behavior, way of approach. Therefore, in the extension of the Carl Jung theory, the theory is highlighting that ambivert. Ambivert means sometimes they may be angry, sometimes they won't be show their angriness to others. Based on the environment only, it's deciding whether they want to show their angriness or not. So normally the athletic people are in the mid-level. They are the ambivert. It's not introvert or not extrovert. They are ambivert characteristics they have much. They are more prone to suffer from the NTP. There is a disease because each names, he compared with some kind of disease name only. In the case of the asthenic, they have the Sacheropronic mental disorder. For these people, they have the manic depressive psychosis. The same issues for the next people, it's called PNIC. The PNIC also the same kind of issue. The PNIC people, the body type, they're very round body. They're fat. They're very short. Sometimes those are very height. You feel those are people's very height. Similarly, fat, you could not feel that they are very fat. So the shortness only showing the fatness of the people. That's why the proportion is, those are very high, they are fat also, we cannot perceive that is very fat because the height may suppress his fatness. So, but in the case of the PNIC stage, the people's may be very short. Because of the reasons, we feel there is very some kind of fat. And there will be have the personality traits of extroverts. What are the characteristics they may showing person? They are very sociable, they are very jolly type, easy to mingle to other ones, and good natured. So whenever you meet this kind of people, the people make us to be happy. And they are also having some kind of disease, according to the Kreshmer. These people are more prone to suffer from the mental disorder called manic depressive psychosis, the same of the athletic people. The last type, dysplastic type. So normally we use the term dysplastic type. So these people, unproportional body. So unproportional body, this is, we cannot predict this much of fat. We cannot predict this much of lean people. So that people, some kind of unproportional body type may be there. So that people we may treat it as a dysplastic type, according to the Kreshmer. He highlighted some of the characteristics also. And don't being to any of the three types mentioned above. So they won't be compared to any three type people. We could not predict their personality also, because they are not come to the any kind of the three body type. They are exceptional. So sometimes the exception, we are using the terms. They are exceptional. We cannot predict the body type. We cannot predict the characteristics of the people immediately. This disproportion is due to hormonal imbalancement. That is this kind of issues, body issues for them is coming. And the behavior and personality are also imbalanced. So we cannot predict. That's why I told the terms, we cannot predict it. So thank you so much. So still now I'm talking about the two important theories.